Hey, y'all, what's up? New Hampshire Dipper back at you for another video. So if y'all watched my last video on, the worst dip ever. No bet, though. My mom, the times my mom caught me with dipping. Now, I think there is. I think there has been a time when our parents caught us dipping. Whenever, if you're a dipper or a smoker or whatever, your parents have caught you doing that. So, I think there are times my mom caught me dipping tobacco. Seems like we're talking about old times. Sips and grizzly when I'm dipping on grizzly wintergreen long coat. My first dip, and the only thing I'll ever do. Unless I'm doing a review or just want something different, and otherwise it's crazy green. So let's see. Now, story begins when I was 17 years old. Now, when I was a kid, when I was 17, and my mom knew I'm dipping, I used to hide shit under my mattress. I didn't really have that really great hiding spots for hiding dip anymore. So, alright, so I went to school, had about 10 with me, and I came home, I was like, oh man, can't wait for a dip. I check under my bed, it's not there, I'm like, oh, fuck. I go upstairs, all my dips stand there on the kitchen table, I'm like, fuck my life. So I was like, John, I was like, oh shit, and I was like, John, dude, you've been chewing tobacco, huh? I was like, yeah. So you realize this stuff has mouth cancer, near mouth cancer, throat cancer, stomach cancer, all that crap. Jaw fall off and all that. I'm like, yeah, mom. She's like, well, you shouldn't be doing that. And then, I had skull citrus bun long cut, and a grizzly wintergreen long cut. I had grizzly straight, coping wintergreen, all that good stuff. And, it was hard for me getting dipped. I mean, in school, I used to bum dips out of everybody, but. Second time my mom caught me with dip. Let's see, my cousin, James, he was 18, and I was 17. I was like, hey, man, buy me a log. Of course, I had money, give my 20 bucks for everybody picking up a log, and I was like, all right. So, and he's like, alright, we're going to keep it down at my house, and at my grandmother's. So, he's like, alright, and I kept it in the freezer. And him and I got into a fight, and the next thing I know, phone rings. It was James, and Mike ended up picking up my dip up, and blah, blah, blah. My stepdad's Mike, by the way, and he picked up my dip, and, yeah. So, and then, yeah. The last time I caught me a dip was, I was in high school, and, yeah. It was pretty bad. But now my mom doesn't give a shit. My mom buys my dip. I buy it. Oh, it's a mixture. I buy my dip. My mom buys my dip. If I'm on low, she'll buy me more. It's how it is. But yeah, that's pretty much it. I mean, my mom's pretty cool shit. She'll buy me dip, shoe, whatever I want. Whoever needs to buy it, it's awesome. For example, like fucking Mountain Dew, dip, video games, you name it, it's fine. It's an awesome perk of being an only child, guys. It's awesome. You're probably wondering, why does it feel like being an only child? Well, number one, you get whatever the fuck you want, when you want. Two, you can, it's pretty cool being an only child. You get whatever the hell you want. The only bad part is you get kind of lonely and not having a brother or sister, but hey, that's what friends are for, right? Fuck, you got an Xbox, talk to Boo, hey man, what's up, Justin, Kyle, hey guys, what's up, and stuff like that. And sisters, you have girl best friends, and it's pretty fun. But my point is, folks, we've all been there. Parents have caught us with dips, cigarettes, chew. It doesn't matter. We've all been caught. Hiker, we got time to kill. In a video, I'd say about my runs with the law in school. Well, when I was 17, no, when I was 18, I caught dipping. I brought a 10 dip to school, and I was dipping in the boys' belt. See, the stalls I went into was, it was Ernol's stall, the big stall. And I was in the middle, having a dip. And I was two teachers, one teacher in the Ernol, one teacher in the big stall. I was like, fuck. They didn't say anything, but then I called the office, and then they were like, and since the principal came in, he's like, Tom Martin, that's 80%. And I was like, okay. And then he went to his office, and he's like, I said, am I in trouble? He's like, nah, no, you're not. He lied. So I went down to the office, and he's like, so, you've been chewing tobacco, huh? And the boy's been like, yeah. He's like, how old are you? For shits and giggles. Well, I'm 18. He's like, you're 18? I was like, yeah. He's like, all right, well, first time, we just get a warning. And get your tobacco back the other day. I was like, well, I seen you that one. Can I have it back then? He's like, yeah, sure. So after that, he's like, so one fourth ball came, and I got my dip, and then fucking I wanted a dip, so I went to the boys' bathroom, packed the fade, and there you go. Second time I caught, I used to fucking give my redneck boys dip because they weren't old enough. You know, a 10 dip, pay $3, and yeah. So, and the second time I got bagged for, you know, tobacco, selling to a minor. I had fucking 19 hours of community service. And that was really it. And I had 5 days of ICS with them. And, you know. So that's pretty much it. My runs of the law. But, yeah. That's about this video. Got more coming up. Nicole Morrison wants me to do. That's my girlfriend, by the way. I think she's my girlfriend, but she's cool shit. Anyway, she wants me to do a Mountain Dew suicide. So, I'm going to go out and buy more Mountain Dew. And